Intelligent Sustainability Design, the Integration of Carbon Accounting and Building Information Modeling, BIM, and about the softwares, specific software. I will skip some of the slides which are very basics. And here we'll discuss about the tools. Evaluate engineering sustainability through LCA, such as building information modeling, and experience of combining BIM and LCA, life cycle analysis methods, its advantages and disadvantages. Why we need such tools, first of all? That's what the primary question I tried to present you. See, the focus on sustainability are becoming integral part of higher education in civil engineering disciplines. LCA has become an important analytical framework. We have, I think, including the like any session on sustainability, we talk about mostly on its principles, its theories, its fundamentals all. But end of the day, actually what is happening is the analysis. That analysis helps you to do all other, the implement of principles, integration with the other analysis, whatever we talked as of now. The actual work is about analysis. The project, the construction projects are very complex, having large amount of material and evaluating one by one is fairly difficult. Comprehending itself is difficult. So that is where need of our intelligent tools to evaluate the energy consumption. These tools have emerged to meet the energy assessment of a project. And we are all aware about building the BIM tools, building integrated management tools, which is through which we can do 3D design, 4D design, 5D design, like drawing, time, cost. Now the sixth dimension is about sustainability. The BIM incorporates sixth dimension is sustainability. So there in the sixth dimension, we do energy analysis, conceptual and both detail, and elements tracking, materials tracking, material flow tracking, and whether it matches with the any certified standards, it would be LEED or VR. The BIM tools work like it permits BIM data structure methods to communicate with other program, enable more integrated designs. It's like you have everything developed in 3D, and that 3D drawings will go for 4D as there we can work out time, there we can work out time actually, and 5D is in cost. But while doing that, you will get a takeoff sheets of the material. And that data, we can communicate with the other programs. Could be a LCA program, either it is a GIBIS or ILUIS, I will show that. And this helps architects, engineers to visualize the effect of change being made for the structure. And from BIM, we can export the data to softwares for energy analysis. Plugins can be installed in BIM itself. There itself, we can do energy analysis. Then we can jump into the another softwares. BIM can integrate with life cycle analysis software such as SimaPro, which is fairly being used in European countries and most part of the world. And also, there are supplement plugins which can installed in BIM itself. That is Green Building Studio, GBS. And IESVE stands for Integrated Environment Solution, Virtual Environment. In this entire thing, I will try to analyze the benefits of the plugins and use of LCA, what we can use like that. SimaPro is analyze the energy in production phase and analyze the entire life cycle with comparing one product to another. But for the SimaPro, material schedules were generated using Revit software. SimaPro only do analysis part, but material takeoffs all comes from the Revit softwares. Then it is assessed in terms of GHG emissions, a global warming potential. For any analysis, we need some approach. In a sustainable idea, we have this cradle to grave, cradle to site, cradle to gate. Such approaches are there. When we study such approaches, we will get to understand how that is beneficial. But with that approaches, we try to analyze the life cycle energy. So construction material processing has become major focus because nearly 40 to 50% of raw material produces 4 to 4.5 tons of carbon dioxide emissions. That's what a study in US. So that's the reason the study of material processing has become major focus while doing life cycle analysis. And life cycle analysis is measuring global warming potential. What is this global warming potential? It is all greenhouse gas, CO2, methane, NO2, are normalized to mass units of CO2 equivalent. You know, often we come across CO2 equivalent. That doesn't include only carbon dioxide, it includes methane and nitrogen also. So this aggregate of, you know, this thing as global warming potential quantifies the carbon intensity. And this framework, a neat framework which explains the integration of BIM software, could be a Revit or something else, and the LCO software. What are the frameworks? First, concepts and design in BIM we do, export the material schedule, analyze global warming potential impact assessment. So then interpretation part comes. And that interpretation we use for our application part, that is to understand whether our project meets the sustainable goals or not, whether it meets the compliance criteria or LED, LEED or BIA, mostly LEED in these softwares we can use, for marketing purpose and other any purposes we make. This is what framework helps in integration of BIM and BIM softwares and life cycle analysis softwares. What are the challenges in integration of BIM tool and LCO? We have seen the what is the benefit of BIM integration of analysis softwares and BIM software. We see what is the framework. Now, there are challenges. One is the data aggregation itself, because construction runs into thousands of rows. The data arranging and aggregation and making it fit to the, you know, transform into the LCO software, which is required in a one format, is a quite complicated but doable. The propagation of moving data from one model to another, process differ to find out variable like volume, etc. Like conversion from volume to square meter, because we do form work in square meter, but LCS software needs the plywood in a volume basis. This conversion required. This is exactly a human interference, like civil engineers is very essential. Civil engineers, I think, unless a practicing engineers or civil engineers present, the integration of our success of these integrations very limited. People should, you know, the person who is sitting on the job should have a good exposure of the units, good exposure of the material, good exposure of the construction practices. This all calls for practical experience. It's just not a integration of two softwares. It needs a practical experience. The interface of practical experience can bring a good energy model. Now we will examine plugins. We studied about LCS software as a standalone with integration and standalone and integration of BIM. And now plugins, which is for the BIM itself, in the BIM itself. Like in the BIM, we use a Revit software. We add one plugin on the top of the Revit software and we'll try to analyze energy analysis there itself. This offers some convenience because, as I told, the conversion problem or export challenges, and the unit conversion, all this can be minimized because you are dealing within one software. Plugins are GBS, Global Building Studio, I said, and IESPE. The GBS uses a regional data and building properties to estimate carbon footprint, operational costs, daylight potential, etc., which reflects local specificity, which is very good. Such offers we may not get in LCS software. If you take SIMAPRO, those standards are embedded based on some European standards or the software which originated, which will not be a much use, like, which is a useful in a manner you can understand. But if you want, like, I mean, sitting in India, I want a understanding of my the material used in India, what happens with that in terms of energy. So that's what help comes from the GBS. This program also explains how adjustment in building operation affect the utility cost and total upstream energy consumption of utility supply. IESPE, this tool requires user input, including weekly operating hours and specification of building. Again, there is a difference between GBS and IESPE. GBS has certain standards in terms of coefficients of operations, utility services, not in terms of a energy standards, which is varying based on the region to region. Whereas IESPE gives an opportunity, you have to feed everything here. Input you have to give, including the utility hours of, it could be electricity, diesel operator, everything. IESPE plugins display results for specific operation energy utilization like heating, cooling, lights, equipment, etc. Whereas GBS tool such breakdown is limited. It's very clear what is the difference between both. The results, there is a study being conducted on both plugins. There is a significant error. which shows the computation results showing difference by both tools of a same building, the GBS gives 36% more than IESVE tool. Authors explain this difference in result from plugins due to the aggregate emission estimate, which do not necessarily translate to precision emission like IESVE. As I informed you earlier, GBS, which comes with certain standards, assuming this material as can do this much, so I'll put up as this much as emission. Whereas IESVE works through specifically with your input, the research says there is a difference between the results are differential between 36%. Carbon emission estimate from GBS and IESVE BIM tool produces inconsistent results, which reinforces the importance of evaluating multiple data sheets and models to generate range of carbon footprint outcomes. The LCS software SIMAPRO results cannot be directly related to BIM energy and carbon assessment plugin, since both approaches have advantage and disadvantage. So what are the advantages and disadvantages? SIMAPRO analysis requires time-intensive data collection, which I told you aggregation of data is much, much bigger, time-consuming, time-demanding. SIMAPRO can report a more comprehensive range of environmental impact. It's very good in bringing out outputs once you are able to aggregate the data. Whereas the BIM tools are quick to learn and use because it is built in the BIM itself. And the plugin refers to geographical climate data and provide informed estimate of energy use. That's one of the plus points. The plugin shows inconsistent results, which I explained why that inconsistent. And author says estimate of fuel and electricity consumption plugin can link to SIMAPRO analysis, since those estimates are based on user input and real estimate. So these are some of the, again, advantages, disadvantages. SIMAPRO analysis requires time limitations, or BIM plugins does not consider the energy consumed for construction process, which is a really setback. Energy demands to the overall carbon footprint. So basically, we have certain limitation with available tool itself and need evolvement. And that is being, you know, done. Even I saw one of my colleague from IITM, he was working on BIM plugin to improve this energy model. So things are continuously evolving, but at this point, these are not completely, you know, go away also. Since we don't have anything, we have better amount of tools to implement with this. We have better amount of tools to get some attention, but it requires some human interface and human effort to achieve a better quality of energy model. I think that's fair enough at this point. When fields are evolving and technology evolving, it will become a complete automation. The effort of integrating BIM tool and LCA helps in accounting carbon footprint view. BIM can be used in two capacities: exporting material schedule indirectly, use of plugins for operational use and carbon emission directly. The study informs BIM plugins give imprecise results, but use of SIMAPRO gives better understanding of LCA and upstream data levels. So upstream data levels is about during construction what the carbon footprint is, which is not being much, you know, given importance or trusted on in plugins. Still, such tools are being evolved. This idea of giving sustainability, I mean, intelligible tool present here is to give us some idea about how, what are the tools we have in hand. We can make use to understand, bring out emissions, energy consumption, and put up our, and relatively see ourselves, how our project is performing in terms of sustainable development. These are all a step towards achieving a sustainable development. Yes, we need to acknowledge there is being work as being like work being done a lot on this field, and we cannot go away from. We have to incorporate as a civil engineers and start working with that, evolve ourselves, and be a prepared for the future expectations. So thank you.